Hey guys, what's going on? I am back with another video, and in today's video, a follow-up to last week's topic, how to shoot a photo time-lapse with your GoPro Hero 9 Black. And in today's video, we are having a look at how to edit the RAW files in Adobe Lightroom and then export the whole sequence into an awesome looking video clip that you can either share on social media or use for your other projects. If this video is helpful, as always, give it a thumbs up, comment on it, share it, because it helps me with the algorithm. And then if you're interested in using my Adobe Lightroom presets or LUTs, there's a link in the description below, follow it. And yeah, thank you so much for supporting the channel in that way. And with that, let's start with how to get the RAW files of your GoPro Hero 9 Black into your computer for editing. So some may recommend to connect the GoPro with the USB-C cable to the computer and then transfer the files that way. But I'm old school. I take the SD card out and use a card reader. For me, personally, it just makes more sense. Card readers come in all different shapes and sizes. I like this one here for my micro SD cards because it's tiny. I can take it anywhere. But otherwise, when I'm using here my MacBook Pro, I use a card reader that it's compatible with both the normal SD cards as well as micro SD cards. It comes with a USB-C cable, so I'm all set. So after your computer recognizes the SD card, you use the Windows Explorer or the Finder to access the SD card, and then you'll find the two different file types. GPR, which stands for GoPro RAW, this is exactly what we're after, and also the JPEG files. So what you're gonna do here now is you select everything and copy it over to a folder on your hard drive. So next we open Adobe Lightroom, the program of our choice today, and then we go into library mode because here it allows us to just drag and drop the files into the program. And for that, the easiest is to sort the files by kind. And then we select all the GoPro RAW files and drag them into the Adobe Lightroom window. So we just ignore JPEG, just the GoPro RAW files. And depending on how many photos you have and how powerful your computer is, it can take a long time. So once everything is selected, just hit import and then let your computer do its thing. And once everything is imported, we can start editing. So let's switch over to the development tab and now let's start the process. And the idea is that we only edit the first photo and then copy everything that we do and apply it to rest of the photos, because the last thing that we want to do is edit every one of these 950 RAW files. And since everything is shot in RAW, we have all the image information available to us, so we can be most flexible, unlike if we would have shot in JPEG. And in our first step, that becomes very apparent because now we can actually change the white balance in post. If you would have shot your time-lapse sequence in JPEG and you picked the wrong white balance, you wouldn't be able to make these adjustments now. But here, you can adjust the temperature, you can adjust the tint. Everything that you want to do is here at your fingertips. I personally liked how I shot it, you know, so I just leave it as it was. So when it comes to these types of shots, landscapes in general, I bring down the highlights and lift the shadows in order to recover all the possible image information that is hidden away in the photo. So now we press the Alt or the Option key to set the whites and the blacks. And for the whites, we want to make sure that nothing really shines through, so we don't clip the highlights. And for the blacks, we push them down a little bit more than we would usually do for the whites, in order to get enough contrast into the photo. So, and please remember, everything that you do here is up to your personal taste. So there is really no right or wrong. But when I personally shoot clouds, what I do is bring down the texture to make them really smooth and fluffy. Same thing for the clarity. Let's bring that down a little bit as well. And then increase dehaze because I want these clouds to really pop. When it comes to the vibrance, same thing. Let's bring it a little bit down. And then since this is a bit dark and moody, I really don't want to have it, you know, too colorful. So saturation will bring down a little bit as well. As a next step, usually I go over the tone curve simply because here we can adjust really the contrast by either lifting the shadows or bring down the highlights. And we can also create a nice S curve to really make this photo pop. And what I'm doing here is now bring down the shadows even a little bit more and lift the highlights a little bit as well, so we can get even a bit more contrast into the photo and make sure that it really pops. So the next part, in my opinion, is the most fun when editing photos in Adobe Lightroom, and that is the HSL tab. Stands for Hue, Saturation and Luminance. And here you can adjust the colors and the brightness of the colors, create a little artwork, and it's really super fun. If you don't feel like, you know, digging into that and you just want to use some Adobe Lightroom presets to get the look that you're after, these are available as well. I also have a bunch of Adobe Lightroom presets available for download. There's a link in the description below. Please follow it, and then you can get some Adobe Lightroom presets to play with. Other than that, let's move on, because if I go here into too much detail, it'll become another 15-20 minute video. So let's move on and let's have a quick look at split toning. With split toning, you can add a color tone to the highlights and shadows separately, which creates a certain look and increases the contrast, which is very common when it comes to Hollywood movies, for instance, where they add a little orange to the highlights and teal to the shadows, that typical orange and teal look. So you can get really creative with this. It's super fun. At the moment, I leave it as it is. Under details, we can increase the sharpening for our photo, especially when we set sharpness to low in the GoPro settings. So here it is, where you can add it back in. And please make sure that you look at the preview window in order to know whether you add too much or too little. I recommend to not go beyond 70, because otherwise it becomes again too sharp, which doesn't make the photo look nice. And now when we press and hold the Option or the Alt key and drag the masking slider, we can really specify where sharpening is being added, because only the structures that shine through now will get sharpened. And we want to make sure that nothing of the clouds come through, because the clouds need to stay fluffy and soft and they shouldn't get any sharpness. And as a next step, we can also add a bit of noise reduction, but let's make sure to not go beyond 50, because otherwise we lose all the details that we just added to the photo. And then what I usually do is remove chromatic aberration. So now that we're happy with the look of our photo, let's make sure that it's cropped properly and that the horizon is straight. So very easy, let's crop it, let's adjust the horizon a little bit more, and now we are all set. What I usually do when it comes to shooting clouds, and maybe a little tip for you, I add a graduated filter over the clouds and then decrease exposure. That really brings a little bit more contrast to the clouds, make them really come out. And especially when you have clouds like this one here, they make them also look a little meaner, a little more aggressive. So now this is it. We've done editing our first photo. Now we want to make sure that we copy everything. So click on the first photo again. So it's selected. Click on copy. And then just to make sure, click on check all, that everything that we've done to this photo is being checked. Click on copy. So all the settings are now being copied. Then click on Command A or Control A for every photo to be selected again. And then let's click on sync. So all the settings that we've done to the first photo are being copied over to all the 950 whatever photos we now have. So super quick, super easy. This way we can apply what we've done to one photo to all the photos in that sequence. And now in the thumbnails, you can see these little icons that indicate that every photo has been edited. Now, let's go to File, Export to export our sequence. First of all, you can choose the export folder. I usually go with the picture folder, and then create a subfolder to make sure that I don't override anything that I need. And then rename your files if you want. Let's give it Clouds as a name. And then as a sequence, the start number is 1. So let's scroll down a little further. Here now we can adjust the quality. I usually go with 100%, and then you can also change the image format if you want. I go with JPEG, but if you want, you can also export in PNG, depending on how much hard drive you have left. It's really up to you. For me, it's JPEG for now. So now this is it. Nothing else for us to do here. Let's hit export and let's Adobe Lightroom do its thing. So everything is being exported. It can take a long time, but then the Adobe Lightroom part of our little endeavor here is done. After all the photos have been exported, we go into our video editing program. For me, it is Final Cut Pro. And then we select all the photos and drag them onto the timeline. Same principle would apply if you edit with Adobe Premiere or any other video editing tool. As a next step, we want to make sure that the duration of each photo is only one frame. For that, right-click when all the photos are still selected, select Change Duration, press 1 on your keyboard, and then Enter. So now we know on our 25 frames per second timeline, we use 25 images per second, which is exactly what we want. Now right-click on the sequence while all the images are still selected. Let's choose New Compound Clip, which combines all these images into one clip. So we can edit this clip as if it would be video footage. So let's zoom in so we see better what we are doing. And the first thing that we want to do is to scale up that footage because we're on a 16:9 timeline. And as you can tell, the photo dimension isn't 16:9. So in order to fill up the whole screen, the easiest is to scale up that footage to 134%. And now in order to reframe our shot, we just need to reposition it within the frame by changing the Y value. And here, obviously, we want to focus on the clouds. So we just adjust it to see the whole sky. So this is it. This is how you would edit a photo sequence that you shot in RAW with the GoPro Hero 9 Black and then edit the photos in Adobe Lightroom and then create the video clip in Final Cut Pro X. And you can still speed up that footage, which is super easy, as if it would be normal video footage. So if you're shooting your sequence and you are not sure what interval to choose, choose an interval that is a little faster, because again, speeding up the footage in post, it's super, super easy. And now finally, after 12 minutes, you earned it, you deserve it. This is our final clip. And I have to say, I'm super happy with the outcome. We did a great job. It looks fantastic. So let's enjoy it. So this is it, my friends. This is how to edit your photo time-lapse sequence that you shot with the GoPro Hero 9 Black in Adobe Lightroom and how to export this as an awesome looking video clip. And I hope this video was helpful. If it was, give it a thumbs up because it helps me and helps the channel grow. If there's anything that I haven't addressed in today's video, any questions you may still have, leave a comment down below and I'll get back to you. And most importantly, if you want to see more GoPro related content of me, subscribe to this channel and hit that bell icon so you get notified when I'm uploading new videos. And with that, as always, I'll catch you guys in my next video.